Yes.
I've killed like 6 out of the top 10 most evil people in the world, and you're gonna threaten me? You drunk?
What?
You won't believe this. I've been presented with the opportunity to join the Basilica Nostra. It must have been from your help. I never thought in my wildest years. I only hope to correct a mistake. It will take time to be approved, but here is your reward with my thanks. Of course, of course. I'm indebted to you. This is the least I could do. The order to set you in Sandstone Villa came from Templar Joriel. She's the one interested in you, and she's in the forum. If you wish to converse with her, you should go quickly. No one knows how long a Templar might remain in one place. According, Joriel is an ex-
Fair enough.
He just gave me armor I didn't want. Let's go put an armor into some dude's inventory. I think I needed 5 of that. Right. Speak with Joriel. Why is Joriel keeping an eye on me? That's suspicious. Or sus, as the kids say.
What?
No, it would be this way, wouldn't it? Hey, thanks.
I do not know how it happened, but here we are. How astute of you to make it to this point. I might have been surprised to be uncovered so quickly, but Edessa is the City of Whispers. I'm almost shocked it took this long for us to meet. I've been trying to rout out elements of our leadership, whose ambitions supersede the will of our people. I only hope I haven't failed. From their council in the Forum, the Templars guide the advancement of our society. Our tremendous successes are due to their unswerving pursuit of knowledge. Each Templar is allowed a wide degree of freedom in the projects they sponsor, but they are ultimately accountable to the rest of the Forum. I have been the one that has orchestrated your observation. There was much to gain, and relatively little to lose. You must understand, I meant no harm. It is an estate that I have ordered to be kept empty for when I have need of it, such as now. Unlike the lofty idealism of the Alpha, and the messy pragmatism of the humans, we gnomes proudly embrace the virtues of reason and order. As such, we must maintain neutrality in these periodic wars that spring up. We cannot risk tainting our knowledge by taking sides, you understand. The shining jewel of knowledge, an oasis of reason and order, carved by the gnomes into the dusty wilds of Dathir. The Praetorians have a saying, an army is but a single being, and every soldier is a weapon it wields. If every common soldier is a weapon, what of you? Certainly a rare commodity in these contested times, if not a kingmaker. Your presence here is too tempting for some of my colleagues, so I observe you to observe them. That is the game we Templars must play. A simple enough question. The answer is unfortunately complicated. I speak with the authority of a Templar. It is enough to make my suspicions law, if need be. So I must remain silent, if I wish to learn what I need. Yes and no. You wield a power new and greater than many are capable of understanding, and to unforeseen repercussions. I worry of that. But greater still is our response to this power, how we approach it, and how we attempt to understand it. This city, our race, is built on the promise of plans reaching fruition, and as convicted as some are, others might be distracted by you. No. To speak frankly, I had intended this observation to be conducted with your awareness. You were never meant to know that someone was watching you. It could make my quarry suspicious. It is a frustrating turn of events. But how did you come here? Who exposed this to you in the first place? Brutin? Bodyguard? I never hired any... Ugh, by Athene. I've been outmaneuvered. Whoever hired Brutin likely knew you would be watched, and knows you're meeting with me. You have to find Brutin. Whoever he's working for, they can't have good plans for you or me. We've been had. I gave you Sandstone Villa, hoping to use it to uncover the Templars, who have been plotting to exploit you for war. But in doing so, my quarry uses their agent Brutin to trace me through you. They'll have both of our heads if we don't stop them.
Okay. Now I must confront and probably kill Brute. Gnomes seem very devious. Yes. They're like Romulans. Yes, they have weird haircuts too.
Well, I've learned enough about your doings to know when I've been found out. Took you long enough. When I was told I'd be targeting a man who came back from the dead, I thought I heard wrong. But then I learned about the Well of Souls. As soon as Juriel's out of the way, my employers will make the well theirs. And all of the power that comes with it.
Yeah, I don't think so. Why are you doing this?
The Templars are not all of like mind for what road our civilization needs to take. Such as my employer. We plan on grander things for our brethren, but some are holding us back, like Joriel. So we'll kill her. Then they can experiment on you. But before that happens, me and the boys will have our fun. Yeah, good hunting.
Well, he's dead. Oh, you're right here.
You've gotten to Brutin then. This was not the outcome I had anticipated. That you were able to deal with it is gratifying. Killing Brutin should send a message to his masters to stop their plans. I heard what he said about my death. It seems I am indebted. With any luck, the serpent will not bite without its fangs. Our business can be concluded. You have proven capable beyond measure. As a reward, I give you the deed to Sandstone Villa. It is now yours, completely. If you wish, you may make improvements to it at the Grand Bursar's. Now, there is much I must attend to. I am off.
Where's the Grand Bursar's? Grand Bursar's is over there. I still find it really strange that they give you literally the best house in the game at the very, very beginning. All these other places have been, like, visually more interesting, but functionally less so. Like, they're a lot harder to get to, they don't have, like, everything's way further apart.
Welcome to the Grand Bursar. We can offer loans, property development opportunities, and oversight on investments made with us. Ah, so you are the new owner. Excellent. Have a pleasant day. Hello again. What can I assist you with? Is that so? We've supplied you with a forge. Should you feel that... Very good. Have a pleasant... Hello again. What can I assist... Is that so? Very well. The labs have graced... You won't regret it. Have a pleasant day. Hello again. What can I assist you with? Regrettably, no. Have a pleasant day. Hello again. What can I... Very well. We'll invest a standard capital on your behalf. We can't promise its return, but we will... Reasonable enough. Have a pleasant day.
Alright, so now the house is fully upgraded. Can we drop off here? Guy kill my healer? He did. What a dick.
fancy you.
Well, my industrious little cloth finder. That's good. Pleasant journeys.
Good tidings.
Need to do any trade? I have some items for sale, or I can buy. Come again.
All right, what do we have? Find Guan Stebek's lab in Apatir.
May I help you?
No, I'm good. Thank you, though. Broken Master's Pick. Oh, I'm still in the building. I forgot about that. Alright, so I've got it, but it's broke.
There is something curious at work here. The Hierophant predicted that you would steal the Master's pick, and you come back with this. I've heeded our seer for years, always speaking truth, always. But this job, this failure, is a fallacy. How could the Hierophant be wrong? Never mind that. There is a more pressing matter at hand. The Hierophant has another task for you. You must pray at the... Be gone.
Classic misdirection.
Do a bit of smithing if that's what you're looking for. For. Got the forge.
Farewell.
And lastly, you arrive. There is something hesitant in your step, I see. But it is not your step that concerns me. I have learned that an enemy of the Travelers is soon to meet his end. Mon Cointaker has been sentenced to execution. His is a sordid life, and his will be a fitting death. He was a cutthroat, a brigand, a highwayman, and former traveler. He left my flock when we would not serve his gruesome tastes, and with his bloody ways he amassed a great fortune coveted by many.
Okay.
It would be if he was not a monster and a cutthroat, but despite this, Mon has amassed a sizable hoard before his arrest. He has cost the Travelers dearly many times. And sullied our name with his murders. Let the Travelers see the price of those that cross me. He is being held in Convict's Cavern in Apatir. He will give you the key to his hoard. This I have foreseen.
Interesting. It's literally like right outside the front door.
You're not supposed to be sniffing around over here. Go on, get. Keep walking.
Thanks.
You there! Halt! Going to make trouble, are you? You're not going.
Hurry up.
Well, looks like one of Arjin's blew in here. Wonder what the guards would do if I called them over. But Morn won't do that, though it sounds a bit of fun. You are a traveler, aren't you? Suppose Sun Camp came to gloat. Rats in the desert fighting over my table scraps. Only now they have a shot at the whole feast. More likable than you spineless travelers, at any rate. I can't believe I ever walked with you cowards. Can take a man's livelihood, but not his life, eh? Oh, come now, I can't be all that bad, can I? Maybe I did slit some throats. They'll still remember me as the richest son of a bitch in Apatir, who laughed in the Hierophant's face. Well, they've welded my door shut until I reach the gallows, so it's yours. But this is only part of the key you'll need. See? I'm a fair man. I gave the other pieces to the Zungars and the Dark Varys. They're looking for my treasure right now, and I don't think they'll share. This is what you scabs get for picking at Morn's bones. Claim my gold if you dare. Arjin can hold my debt fulfilled if you survive. Ah, my old stomping grounds. Would that I could see it now, filled with eager Zungars and Dark Varys, spilling their blood for my gold. It's hidden in Snaketail Grotto, but the Zung... Good hunting!
Hey!
Alright, let's get out of here.
What do you want?
A leave, apparently? Thank you. We got some cool stuff. I'll take all their stuff. Let's head this way. There's a bunch of dudes over here. Ouch, that looks painful. Still looking for one piece of that weird new ore that that one guy wanted. Thank you. Man, my nose itches. Oh, that's what I'm gonna open with the key. Okay. I'm gonna open his treasure and it's gonna say the greatest treasure is friendship.
Looks like Mon managed to pull a fast one on pretty much everyone. You know, I remember a time when the Hierophant couldn't be faulted, couldn't be fallible. Guess that's just sand in the desert breeze, Dove. I've found the missives of Sable and how to get them. I need you to steal them for me. The Hierophant's power is clearly waning, and all the travelers will suffer for it eventually.
I chose this path because of vengeance. I was wrong. It's the future of the Travelers what's at stake. It's the giant, ornately carved stone bloody feather in the gnome's enormous cap, that's what it is. The gnomes built a warren into that crater, and a secret one at that. The safest fort in the Phalanx, and we're robbing it. Amongst Travelers was the best place to be before this Hierophant led us astray. We'll be recapturing that freedom, Dove, with that book you'll be stealing. With a proper bit of skill, you're going where no thief of these lands has stepped foot, in the vaults beneath the Edessa Livrarium. Seems to be where the gnomes hide what they don't want found, missives included. I've arranged for Phasma to meet you there and show you the way in. He knows as much as I've told him. I'd have shown you the place myself, but after own stand, I might be recognized. Phasma's got a good head on his shoulders. He'll help you just fine. These are gnomes we're dealing with, Dove. Forget gold, wine, and power. They prize knowledge above all else. I suspect something to be in those missives that means a great deal to them. But who cares? They've got the book, and we want it. Now go. When you've got it, I'll be waiting for you with some friends in the Hospitalis quarters. We're close, Dove. We'll be ridding the Travelers of that problem soon enough, right after you get the missives of Sable. I ain't exactly what you call literate, Dove, but all our fortunes lie with that tome. Yours, mine, and the Hierophant's. I need you to do the impossible. Lucky for us, get on with you.
Okay.
Well done. I was worried the Zangar boys might give you a bit of trouble. I was right about you. I have an eye for promise, you know. Prospecting, as the locals would call it. I've noticed your weapons. I assume you know how to use them? It's a pity, but the only way to clean up Whitestone will be to get them dirty. We've received news that Adath Scoria might be hiding out with the Cynric family in their old Terrenium quarry. Get down there and take a look. See what you can see. The quarry is very near, in the canyon to the south. It's the most important facility in Apotir. Not a piece of ore can be refined without it. It's a pity the Cynric family won't let anyone inside.
Already been in there.
It's the processing facility for all ore leaving Apotir. The gnomes built it soon after they completed their headquarters. The Cynric family has run it ever since.
Okay.
Careful out there.
Need to sell before I leave.
Hey there. I'm at your service, friend. Take a look at the merch. See you soon.
like my third or fourth time down in this quarry.
What are you doing all the way down here? You'd think the Cynrix would be enough to keep anyone away.
We have no leaders here. We are a family. I speak for the miners of Scoria only because I'm tired of the treatment and I care not if I live or die. To the fires with the Darkvari, the Cynrix and the Zungars. They chose their paths as we did Scoria's. There is still such a thing as pride, as dignity. What has that snake told you? That I sold him Scoria mine? I would never do such a thing. Just because he lives in the mayor's house doesn't mean he's a man of honor. Came here 6 months ago saying he was going to revitalize Whitestone. Ever since, my people have been captured or killed by his marauding hired swords. I remember when my uncles brought me to see it for the first time. Not long after the gnomes hired Papa Kester to be the first of our foremen, I found it beautiful. We have mined it for decades. No new mayor is going to take from us what has been earned through sweat and heartache. Yes, I know what you're thinking. What am I doing here? You should try living in a village where the mayor wants you dead. The miners of Apotea know Cynric Quarry well. It's a second home to most of us, where we once extracted Tyrrhenium and exported it to Edessa. While I don't agree with what the Cynrix are doing to survive, I do respect their refusal to back down. I was born and raised in these shafts and tunnels. The gnomes gave my people hope, only to turn their backs on us in our time of greatest need. Before the recent ordeal, Whitestone was more than a village. It was a community. We cared for one another. We worked through our challenges together. An agent of that snake Eswin, no doubt. You're not the first one he sent to scare me from my mine. I'll tell you what I've told the rest. That claim is Scoria property. You can kill me, but it won't matter. Politicians come and go. They follow the money. But a man protecting his land will never leave it. You tell him that. If you wish to do the right thing, and there is a right thing, meet me later. I'll be staying with allies in Whitestone. It's the last place Eswin would look. Together you and I can save Apotea. I'm in hiding from Eswin's hired swords. Men and women like you. But I can see that you're a reasonable person. Do the right thing. Come see me again.
So I'll return, tell him I couldn't find the guy. And then we'll meet him afterwards. all these little rocks to catch you.
Turn unless you had something to tell me, am I right? Oh, I'd have laid it out for you, did he? Should have expected that. Well, let me put it this way. The days of the family mines are over. A new order has come to Apotir. The Darkvari, Sinrix, and the Zungars. I will deal with them in time. But the Scorias, they are different. They have the people's respect. And that is powerful. Listen to me carefully. If you walk away from this, from me, you will no longer be welcome in Whitestone. So tell me, friend, are we still partners? Do you have any choice? You just wait. Without me, without Whitestone, Apotir will continue to dry up like the husk it's become. But we can stop it. We organize all the claims under single ownership. Mine. And work with the gnomes to get the ore flowing again. Prosperity will return, and with it, the people.
This is a decision you will regret. You have my word on that.
Mind yourself.
Hey there, how can I help? I thought I could smell.
Mind yourself.
Hey there, I'm at your service, friend. Take a look at the merchandise and let me know what you think. What can I say? He's an old friend, one of the oldest. The Scorias have done more than anyone for this town. Without them, Whitestone would be a festering ditch. No one from the outside could understand what we've been through, with the gnomes and now the mayor. It's time for the people of Whitestone to forge their own destiny. He's nothing more than a bully and a tyrant. Burn the mayor and his selfish claims to Whitestone. See you soon.
Oh, he's upstairs. I was all like, it's... Why is it not...
You came back? I'd hope to the heavens, but... Well... It's hard to trust hope when you've lost everything. I have a proposition for you, if you're willing to take a risk to do what's best for the people of Apotir. Our family mine is all we have left, and Eswin wishes to take that from us as well. He knows, as I do, that Scoria mine still bleeds the valuable ore, and he wants it. The reason is simple. Eswin is an outsider, yet he wishes to steal all that the people of Apotir have built, have slaved over. He has no right to this land. Don't you see? At heart, down deep beneath the finery and heavy pockets, he is a common criminal, a thug like his men. Go to the mine and recover a sample of Tyrrhenium and bring it back to me. Sounds like a simple task, doesn't it? You just wait. Take this ring. It is a Scoria family heirloom. It will help earn my cousin's trust. They guard the mine from bandits and mercenaries. It is across the trench near the empty old Motus headquarters.
Thank you. Yeah, it's there. East. Man, here's that stuff you needed. Or were you? He was upstairs. Never mind.
My calculations were correct. A vein of colmonite runs beneath us, and there's no telling how far it stretches. Do you know what you've done? You've rescued Apatir. Take this gold. It's nothing compared to the reward that's coming. A rebirth of a region. Motis mining interests will learn not to disregard Ruin Amos.
So that's done.
I'm reluctant to ask who you are. You see, we've had many visitors lately, and every one of them has meant us harm. I am Thelgood Scoria, and this is my mine. This mine is ours, so long as the Terrenium remains. Those are the terms of the deed. He can talk to Motus mining interests in Hollowlands if he wishes to dispute it. This mine is Scoria-owned and operated, and I'm not about to let some scraggly pit pony go assaying it. Besides, we've had to shut down operations on account of the beasties, not the ones outside. These are new. A few days ago, in the stope, we struck something. What came out of that hole was nothing like I'd seen. Killed most of my men. Now we can't go down there, and neither can you. So turn around and start walking. You know Adath? Well, you look like the kind of person he'd drag into the middle of this. Desperate. It's your choice. Have a go. I'm not gonna bury you.
Yep, that's what I thought it would be. I guess that's his other cousin. Am I taking this back to, oh yeah, okay. Just through here. Like I said, I wouldn't be welcome back in town, but there's not a stop.
I'm at your service, friend. Take a look at the merchant.
Come again.
You went to Scoria. I wasn't convinced anyone could survive the evils awakened there. But you've proved tougher than expected. Making the mine safe again is a task for another day. Right now, we have a more dangerous challenge before us. It's time to kill the mayor of Whitestone. It's the only way. Once he's gone, I can take his place and help save Apotea for its people, not for a man who wishes to be king. I imagine he sits on his makeshift throne in the mayor's cottage. Go.
I think I'm gonna stop here for tonight, everybody.